Hi, I'm Core Crossan. This is Crossan Sees, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about tips and tricks on finding the right hashtags, mostly for Instagram, but also for other social media platforms. Now, that being said, remember to like, share, subscribe. Also, if you want to know my number one way to make money online, click on the link in the description box below, get on my email list, and watch that video afterwards, because it's a video that I watched when I first started getting into business, and it really got me connected to a bunch of entrepreneurs and a bunch of people that really helped and support me starting my business. So that being said, let's go check out those hashtags.
All right, so we're going to be hashing the tags, tips, and tricks. So we're going to be looking at hashtags and how they can help you on social media. Here's some tips, and let's get to it. All right, tip number one, make sure they are relevant. So your tags need to be pinpoint, they need to be relevant. The more relevant they are, the better, because you want the right audience looking at your content, because the wrong audience plus great content is bad. It's bad for retention. If people aren't looking at your post, not liking it, not engaging with it, then the algorithm's not going to pick it up and your post isn't going to go viral. And you want to make sure that you have every chance to make your post go viral. So a good example of this would be something like posting a lot about how you're rebuilding your truck and it's a manual transmission. But then all of a sudden you get the bright idea. You see how many people are searching for automatic transmission and you want those people looking engaged with your content. Well, a bad idea would be putting the hashtag automatic transmission on there and then a bunch of keywords related to automatic transmissions. The reason being is because people who are looking for automatic transmissions are not looking for manual transmissions. And so they'll look at your content, not engage with it, and the algorithm will see that. And even though you have great content, it's the wrong audience. And so it's not going to get picked up. All right, let's go to tip number two. All right, don't spam tags, okay? So too many tags will hurt your reach on some platforms. I don't know when spamming tags is ever good. Because if you made your post right, if you made it niche specific, you won't have that many relevant tags to put on there anyway. And then I believe on Facebook, I wish I had my numbers. I had it somewhere, but I lost it. But on Facebook, I believe it's like 3 tags gets you the best reach. So the most pinpoint, the most relevant tags, put them on your posts. Too many tags will hurt your reach. I believe it also has to do with having relevant hashtags, because after a while, you just won't have tags that are relevant to your posts. All right, tip number three, use a mix of high and low volume tags, especially when just starting out. You'll see a lot of tags that have like 1,000 searches and above. Like 1,000 searches on some of the social media sites is nothing, right? And so you'll see some with millions, like a whole bunch. And so the high volume tags are going to be very hard to rank for, especially if you have if you're just a brand new account and everything. So you want to have a mix. So the low volume tags are very specific. So you might actually want to start off focusing your content around these low volume tags and building up your following from there. Once your following is large enough, you could start ranking and showing up for the larger tags. Oh, and so when you have a mix of low and volume, sometimes the low volume tags will help you rank for those. And then as engagement reaches, the high volume tags you'll start to show up for and your post will go viral. That being said, tags don't make up for bad content. And I should know, I tried, I put up like so many posts about this, like bad motivational posts. And the reason why I'm putting out these tips is because I've done all these things wrong and it just doesn't work. And I found that actually just providing value, putting relative tags and doing the best content that you can is actually better than just throwing garbage out there. So tags don't make up for bad content. I should know, I tried. Tags help good content get to the people who will enjoy it. So now you got the tips, now let's get the tricks. Now here are some tricks to finding tags that work. All right, so this following one will work on any social media platform that you're on. Follow successful accounts and copy what they have. Oh yeah, copy what they have. It works on any platform. That being said, if certain tags with like a million followers, They'll rank for those tags. But you have to find an account close to you, or one that is not that far ahead of you, or one that's just successful and maybe not as blown up, but is still getting to where you need to be. And then look at their tags, look at their content, and mimic them. I wouldn't suggest just ripping them off, but mimic them. Do the same kind of things. If they're doing, I remember when the cards, and you just drop the cards and no one's talking and you just read it, that was real popular for a while. And TikTok, those weird little dances go in and out of phase. So if you really want to catch on a trend, trends are real powerful too. So just follow these accounts and look at them, and then follow their, see what they're hashtagging and see if it's relevant to your account, and see if you can do the same. And for Instagram, use resources like displaypurposes.com. Displaypurposes.com is free, and it basically, you go in there, you can see the graph, you can rank your keywords, type in a relevant keyword to your post, and it'll come out with a bunch of hashtags. You can pick the ones you want, or you can copy them all and paste them. Also, one that I like is AI Schedule. They do a great job with hashtag research, and also you're able to schedule your posts. The free account's like $5 a month, but then the paid account's only $7. So that being said, I think AI Schedule is a really great resource, and same with Display Purposes. I use them both. That's the tips and tricks for hashtags. I hope this works. I know it was a short video. I just wanted to get in, get out, hit it, quit it. Let's go. So that being said, remember to like, share, subscribe. Also in the description box below, you'll see my number one way to make money online. Click on it and enter your name and email. Watch a video that really helped point me in the right direction, and I hope it will point you in the right direction as well. And yeah, that being said, have a good one, and keep hashing those tags.